Sarah Ruth Apio, the head teacher of Lango Quran Primary School in Leira City, says many Muslim girls are dropping out of school at a fast rate. She says the biggest drivers are abuse at home and poverty.
Iwa yom mene ni dini me Islam tia katoa ha. Me opening.
You should get educated because the future of this country depends on those who are educated. A child who does not get an education has a bleak future and will remain behind. We would have deprived that child. Our appeal to the leaders is to let the school be conducive for learning. As a city, we are ready to support the development of the school. Recently, we set up a latrine at the school and we intend to fence the compound. Zainabu Ajwang, the chairperson of Muslim Women at Idi Amin Mosque, says after hearing about the high rate of school dropouts of Muslim girls, they decided to conduct a fundraising drive. Most of these girls are either orphans or come from single-parent households. It is painful to see them seated at home while their counterparts are in school. When I was talking to them last night, the mothers were shedding tears. They thought I had gone with scholastic materials so that their daughters could go to school the following day. These girls don't have even the basic necessities as a girl should have. Some sat PLE last year and are supposed to join secondary, but there's no hope. Muslim women are languishing in poverty because their faith does not allow them to borrow from commercial banks. We are not allowed to take loans that attract interest. My humble request to our leaders is this: ask the government to avail the Muslim community with interest-free loans.
Work hard and look for money to buy basic needs for their children. Example, food, clothing, and other many more.
Most parents should stop forcing their girls for early marriages, bearing in mind that if their children study, they themselves will benefit more.
Report by Hudson Apunyo for the news in Leira.